Hallelujah. There's nothing we can do, Yisrael, without Yahshua on our side. My mind goes back to, as often as our king talks about, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. If it had not been for Yahshua on their side, they would have been consumed in the fire, Yisrael. Were they not in the furnace? Did not the king command that furnace be heated hotter and hotter? And if it got so hot that those that stood around that furnace, they were consumed by the heat. But yet Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the fire did not even touch them, Yisrael. Why do you think we're not consumed, Yisrael? Don't you know we're in the midst of a furnace? Don't you know that the trials of this life, it seems to grow hotter and hotter? What happens when you're faced with heat, Yisrael? You start to sweat, you perspire. You even get a little weak, do you not? You stay out in the sun too long, you got to have some water. The heat start getting to you. Sometimes you start seeing things that are not there. But because we have Yahshua, hallelujah. How many can make that claim today, Yisrael? Because we have Yahshua on our side, hallelujah, we're able to overcome all things. Even these fiery temptations, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, there's nothing we could do without Yahshua on our side. If Yahshua had not been in that furnace with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they would have been consumed. Hallelujah. So I barak Yah for Yahshua today. That even though we're in this furnace, Yisrael, and there's no way to escape, yet we have Yahshua. He is our escape. Hallelujah. He's the one that we can go to. We cannot go to anyone else. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I do want to continue on with, if I may say, this series concerning the sevenfold voices of Almighty Yahweh. And I just want to touch on a few of the earlier voices before I move on to this voice. In Tehillim Psalms 29, verse 7. Hallelujah. But let us move to the first verse of that chapter before I get to the seventh verse. He says, Dawid, he exclaims, to give unto Yahweh. O you mighty, give unto Yahweh splendor, honor, and strength. He says to give to Yahweh the honor that is due unto his name. How are we physically possible? Or how are we able to do that, Yisrael? Give Yahweh the honor, all the honor that is due to him. How are we able to do that? We don't have enough voice or even enough time in this lifetime to give Yahweh all the honor. Hallelujah. But yet if we walk in his Torah and his Mishpah and obey him, which is one of the simplest things that is written in the Torah, hallelujah, we can give him the honor that is due to his name. He says to worship Yahweh in the beauty of Kodeshness, just in the beauty of walking upright, Yisrael, walking in his statutes, obeying his commandments. Verse 3, the voice of Yahweh is upon the waters. How many of us remember me talking or teaching about the waters? Hallelujah. No matter how high the waters rose, no matter how the storms came, yet Yahshua, he was able to walk upon the waters, Yisrael. We're able to walk upon our troubles. Walk upon the waters that did not consume us. And even when it seems like we're falling through, yet his hand reaches down to pick us up. The Almighty of splendor, he thunders. We talked about the thunders. Yahweh is upon many waters. Verse 4. The voice of Yahweh, it is powerful. The voice of Yahweh is full of majesty or honor, splendor, beauty. The voice of Yahweh breaks the cedars. How many of us remember the cedars, talking about the cedars, the pillars? Hallelujah. Even as Yisrael rose up in its own strength, yet Yahweh brought her low. Yahweh breaks the cedars, even the cedars of Lebanon. He makes also the calf to skip. Lebanon and Syrian like a young wild ox. And we did talk about that a little, about how we watch the birth of the sheep, hallelujah, even of the cattle. And even after just a few minutes of them walking, just getting on their feet, it takes us weeks as children to start walking. But yet that calf, within a few hours, it's on its feet, it's running with life, it's jumping around Yisrael. And now to verse 7, what we're going to talk about on this day. The voice of Yahweh divides the flames of fire. He divides the flames of fire. Well, what is that, Zaken Yeramiah? Well, there are many revelations to this one scripture, Yisrael. But I just want to just touch on what Yahweh has placed on my heart for you all today concerning the fiery trials, Yisrael. Yahweh, he has promised unto Yisrael that he will not put on us more than we could bear. Sometimes it seems like we're just at the edge of it all. That we cannot press any farther. But just as the Torah talks about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they knew what trial that they was heading toward. They knew by not obeying that proclamation of the king that went forth for them not to bow unto their idols or to the music of the sackbut and the instruments that will play, they knew the judgment, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Do we understand the judgment even of this world against the house of Yisrael? They desire to burn us. They desire to destroy us. But yet Yahweh would not allow them to go but so far. He draws the line, Yisrael. But we don't have the power to draw the line and say, oh, Satan, now you're not coming. No, no, Yahshua already drew that line. So all we have to do is just stand on what Yahshua said. All we have to do is stand on the Torah. Satan, the Torah says, you will not go this far. Hallelujah. Even the trials of Job, if we look back, he took them through the ringer, if I must say. He tried them. He tested him. Even to the point that his flesh was even falling off his bone. That was a type of furnace. It was a type of trial, Yisrael. But yet Yahweh drew the line. He said, you can do what you can, what you want, Satan, but you cannot take his life. Satan, he cannot take our life, Yisrael. But yet there's a fiery trial that we all must go through. So what does Yahweh do? He'll hover his people. His heart, his mind is upon us daily because he claims us, or he says that we are his tzaddikim. So what does he do? He divides the trials. He divides the fire, Yisrael. He's not going to put more on you than you can bear. He knows that you have to grow in him. There's us, many of us, or a few of us that's been in here or been in this for a long time. And it seems like at this time that the trials are much tougher and much harder. Even though we have more knowledge than we had when we first started out, even though we have more faith, more emunah than we had when we first started out, it doesn't seem like the trials, it don't seem like they're getting easier, Yisrael. Why? Because it's Yahweh that divides the trials. And it's Yahweh that divides the flames of the fire. He cuts each piece to what we can bear and what we can handle, Yisrael. How many of you ever gathered around a cake when your mama, or he would make cakes, and you would sit around that thing as he puts that icing, somebody he may give the bowl to, and of course in our house, you had to share with 4 or 5. He makes the frosting. He will make that frosting. I know you can buy it at the store, but it's nothing like the homemade frosting is right now. He'll make that frosting in that bowl and whip it up with that confectionate sugar. Add a little flavoring to it. Keep whipping that thing. And it's all beautiful, but you can't wait till that cake's complete. And when it's done, boys, y'all come here. He takes that knife. You know what he's about to do. What is he about to do? He's about to divide that cake up. And, you know, my advice, it don't matter if you was that big or this big, your pieces were all the same. Hallelujah. Even though you wanted a bigger piece, Yahweh, he knows how much we need, Yisrael. He knows how much we can bear, whether it's a small slice or whether he gives us a nice big wedge. He knows how to divide the trials. Well, that's a long way to express on the cake, is it not? That's what we should look forward to as a people. Hallelujah. We should look forward to the trials of this life. Why? Because through those trials, through the heat, through the fire, we are made pure. When gold is tried in the fire, is the gold consumed in the flames? Or is the impurities in the gold consumed? The impurities burn. It's the impurities that do not stand the test of the fire. So even though we are being tried as gold in the fire, Yisrael, you may feel the heat of that. Hallelujah. You may even feel a little pain here and there. But yet it's just the dross being burnt in us, Yisrael. Hallelujah. It is the righteousness that shall come forth out of these trials. Hallelujah. That we will be able to redeem. Oh, that is valuable, Yisrael. So let us not allow our minds and our flesh and our hearts be so much upon what we're going through in the agony of it, but what shall be produced afterwards. Hallelujah. I remember the song that the Whinies used to sing, and I'm a young man, but yeah, I still remember a few songs of the Whinies in the old days. That after the rain, the sun is going to shine again. The sun is going to shine. No matter how long the storm last, or no matter how far it seems at the night, even though you look for the morning, it seems like it never comes, but yet there should be a day, a morning that should come for us, Yisrael. Hallelujah. And the sun of righteousness, Yahshua HaMashiach, he shall shine once again. Hallelujah. I do pray this message be an inspiration to your life today, Yisrael. Just bear with me. I do not plan to be before us long today, but I want us to get the logistics of what I want to talk about concerning the flames of the fire. Yahweh dividing the flames. Hallelujah. I want to begin in Exodus, Shemoth, chapter 13, verse 7. Hallelujah. Talk about Yosef, Yisrael, coming forth unto Ithar. There's a journey that we all must take, Yisrael. And we cannot think that it's going to be easy. Hallelujah. There shall be trials and temptations ahead of us. It says in Exodus chapter 13, verse 17, and it came to pass when Pharaoh had let the people go, talk about Yisrael, that Yahweh, he led. He naha. He led. He provided a way. He said, this is the path that you should take. Walk behind me. That's what a leader does. You follow a leader. Here's one that is able to establish a path for those that follow him to go in. He led them not through the way of the land of the Philistines, although it was near, although it was shorter. Don't you know there's a shorter way? It's always an easier way to do things. Like I said, there's more than one way to skin a cat. But I guarantee there's an easier way. There may be one way to build a house. I mean, many ways to build a house. But there's only one path that is easiest, Yisrael. But Yahweh, he chose in this to go the long way around. Why? Because he knew that the people of Mizraim coming out of Egypt, they were not prepared for a certain thing. What was that? I will get into that, Yisrael. He said, although that it was near, for Yahweh said, let peradventure the people repent when they see war. There was war that was taking place. And all that would have happened, they would have got entangled in it. They would have seen the battle. They would have seen those that were slain because of the battle. And they would have gave up. They would have lost heart, Yisrael. Why? Because they were not ready. Yahweh knew they were not ready to see war. He said, let's prevent the people repent when they see war, and they what? Return unto Egypt. Would we return unto Egypt, Yisrael, seeing the battle, seeing this furnace of this trial, this fire that we are about to embark upon, that we are about to enter into? Does it cause us to lose heart? Does it cause us to doubt, Yisrael, the Torah that Yahweh has placed in us? The things we have heard, the things we have experienced, Yisrael, the things we have seen, you mean to tell me that will cause us seeing the battle, seeing the fire, seeing the furnace, will cause us to turn, backslide like a heifer? to our old ways, to return unto Mizraim. If they would have not turned, they turned or went the short way, if they would have went the short way, they would have turned. Yahweh knows. He knows what they were able to bear, what they were able to endure, Yisra'iyah. So what he do? He took the long way around. He took the long way around. Yahweh's taking us the long way around. Why? That he may have time to teach us, time to prepare us. He's just cutting us a small slice. He said, you just take a little bit at a time, and as you get older, as you get stronger, I will increase that slice. I am Yahweh that divides the flames of fire. But Yahweh, he led the people about through the way of the wilderness of the Red Sea. And the children of Yisra'iyah went up harnessed, they were prepared, out of the land of Mizraim, Egypt. And Moshe, he also took the bones of Yosef with him. For he had straightly sworn to the children of Yisra'iyah, saying, Yahweh will surely visit you, and you shall carry up my bones away hence with you. Are we waiting for the visitation of Almighty Yahweh Yisra'iyah? And they took their journey from Succoth and encamped in Etham in the edge of the wilderness. Verse 21. And Yahweh went before them by day in a pillar of cloud and a staff. It was easy to see. They didn't confuse this with the other clouds that was in the midst of the Shemayim. But it said that it was a pillar. It stood. It was a shaft of cloud. He led them by a pillar of cloud to lead them in the direct, in the way. And it says here, and by night, can you see the clouds at night, Yisra'iyah? Unless the moon is shining and reflecting, you cannot see clouds at the nighttime. So what did Yahweh do? By night, it says a pillar of fire. A pillar of ish, a pillar of fire. Why? To give them ore, to give them light. Don't you know that Yahweh is leading us, Yisra'iyah, by the fire of his Torah, of his mishvah? His word should be like as a fire that is shut up in our bones, Yisra'iyah, that we cannot sit still. It ought to cause us to move in the right direction, not in the wrong direction, Yisra'iyah. So he leads us in this nighttime season. Are we not in this season of darkness? We see darkness all around us. Even in this political atmosphere at this time, you got those that are fighting for position, for rank. All it is for money. That's all it is. They be set well. Tell somebody what to do. That's all they want, Yisra'iyah. They don't care about the people. Romney don't. He don't care, nor does Obama. They don't care about the house of Yisra'iyah. No, they don't. No, they don't, Yisra'iyah. But yet in this time of darkness, he leads us by his oil, by his light, Yahshua HaMashiach, to go by day and by night. So no matter whether it's by daytime or whether it's by the night season, Yahweh leads us, Yisra'iyah. He leads us. 22, verse 22. He took not away the pillar of cloud by day. What would happen if he took away the pillar of cloud or his leading, his ruah from us, Yisra'iyah? We wouldn't know where to go. We wouldn't press into the battle. We would turn away. Did not he say that Yisra'iyah, as they came out of Mizraim, if he would have took them the shorter way and they seen battle, they would have turned back. We would have turned back, Yisra'iyah, if it wasn't for the ruach of Yahweh leading us. Nor the pillar of fire by night. What if he took away the pillar of fire by night? The fire that leads us. The fire that presses us on, Yisra'iyah. His Torah that has showed up in us. There would be no hope for us. There wouldn't be any desire in us to do his mishvah, to obey his commandments. But it says, I'm going to read the verse again, verse 22. He took not away the pillar of cloud by day, nor the pillar of fire by night from before the people. What would have happened? Where would we be if it had not been for Yahshua on our side, Yisra'iyah? If Yahweh would have took Yahshua HaMashiach from before us, took his Torah, his mishpah from us, Yisra'iyah, we wouldn't know where to go. We would be blind, a blind people, leading one another into the ditch. Hallelujah. Let's go to Ezra. Ezra 3, chapter 16, verse 73. I want to begin reading. Hallelujah. One thing for sure, Yahweh, he know how to lead his people, Yisrael. But the enemy, he's also skillful at trying to divert us off of the right path. See, we're on this highway into the Melkut, into the kingdom, but yet there's many turns on the way. There's bypasses. There's what you call them, ramps that take you into the nearest town. Sometimes you're riding down the highway, you get a little hungry. There's always a burger joint up on that sign. Exit 35, McDonald's, Walmart. He placed all these things on the side of the straight way to try to divert us, Yisrael. But we know that we must endure, whether it's hunger, whether it's pain, and stay on the path into the kingdom. Ezra 3, chapter 16, verse 73. Then shall they be known who are my chosen. This is talking about a time, Yisrael. They shall be tried as gold in the fire. How many of us are in the fire today, Yisrael? How many of us are going through a trial today? Hallelujah. Tried. Hallelujah. Don't you know that's how we are known, Yisrael? He said there, then shall they be known. Then shall they be known. How do you know a boxer is an excellent boxer or a football player is an excellent football player? They can talk all the game they want. You find some of the smallest of them, they got the most game. But what is the trial? What makes their word or what they say stand when they're in the fight? When they're in the fight, they can have all those fancy moves and have all the fancy dancing. They can throw the left, throw the right. But until they get in that ring, you really don't know what they're made of. That's just air. Hallelujah. We're in the ring, Israel. And all the way, we're going to be known that we are the people, that we are the condition. The chosen of Yahweh is by this scripture. It's by the trials of the fire. Hallelujah. Then shall they be known who are my chosen, my elect. They shall be tried as gold in the fire. Hallelujah. The fire of this temptation. It shall not seem like it's a strange thing to us, Yisrael. Well, I'm going through this and I'm going through that. Somebody help me. I don't know. It shouldn't be a strange thing. Why? Because we are the chosen. We are the gold that has to be purified. Verse 74. Hear, O you, my beloved. We are his beloved, Yisrael. Don't let Satan or anyone tell you that Yahweh hates Yisrael. Hallelujah. We are his beloved. He says this, O you, my beloved, saith Yahweh, behold, the days of trouble are at hand. Are we not in this days of trouble, Yisrael? But I, not Mokom, not Melech, not Buddha, not Jesus Christ, not the Lord. But he said, I will. He is going to. He wants to. He has spoken it. He said, I will deliver you from the same. I will deliver you from the fire. I will deliver you from the trial. Were not Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, were they not delivered, Yisrael? Even though they was in the midst of that fire, they was delivered. Hallelujah. Why? Because they knew in whom they believed in. They did not waver. They did not doubt. They said, King, you can do what you want to. That's all right. Even if Yahweh takes our life, hallelujah, we will not yet give in unto you. And if Yahweh takes our life, we should have always given our lives. Have we not been bought with a price? So what is our life? Is it to live how we want to and do what we want to and when we want to and how we want to, Yisrael? No, our lives have been paid for by the dam of Yahshua HaMashiach. Look at what Yahshua HaMashiach had to go through. Was it easy? No, it was not. He was a Torah. He was the Mishpah of Yahweh. But yet because he endured this race, or he endured it to the end of all things, he overcame Yisrael. We must do the exact same thing. It's not going to be any easier for us, Yisrael. We must go through the fire. But yet Yahweh, he knows how to divide the flames, Yisrael. Hallelujah. He know what you can bear. He know what you can bear. He know what you can overcome and what you can take, Yisrael. So if we're in the midst having this knowledge, we have the Emunah, no matter what comes our way, we must understand that evidently Yahweh has given us the tools or the armament to endure and to overcome, Yisrael. So why do we give up so easy in the midst of the battle, Yisrael? Hallelujah. Why do we give in to the flesh? Why, Yisrael, when Yahweh has provided so much? He's not going to make you endure or go through that, but yet you must have the ahava and the will and his ruah in you, that you know that you must go through that to reach what's on the other side. Hallelujah. I told the Yahweh. Verse 75. He said, be you afraid, neither doubt. Is that what it's saying? Who has that? Do we? It says what? Do not. He said, be you not afraid. Are we afraid, Israel? Are we cowering down? Are we running away with our tails between our legs as an old dog would do? He said, be you not afraid, neither doubt, for Yahweh is your guide. Did I not talk about the guide? Did I not talk about the pillar of cloud? And even the fire, the pillar of fire? Don't you know that even though we're in the midst of this fire, that it is a guide, that it shows us, it directs us? You feel heat on your right side, you're going to move to the left, aren't you, Yisrael? If it's burning you on your left, you're going to move to the right. And if it's behind you, you're sure enough going to move forward. So even the heat, even this fire, his mishpah, his Torah, it is a guide. It leads us. He has not taken that away from us, Yisrael. Be you not afraid, neither doubt, for Yahweh, he is your guide. Verse 76. And the guide of them who what? Keep my commandments and my precepts. There we have it right there, Yisrael. Are we keeping the commandments? Have we established his precepts in our heart? Have we hid it there, as it were, a precious piece of gold or a jewel, Yisrael? He said, he is a guide to them who keeps his commandments and his precepts, saith Almighty Yahweh. He said, let not your sins weigh you down. That's a weight for us, Yisrael, our sins. When we sin, and when we sin, and we know we're sinning, we know that if I do this, it's transgressing the Torah. So we found ourselves between a rock and a fire. You're not going to get past the rock. You know you have to run through the fire. Hallelujah. We must go through the fire, Yisrael. There's no other way. We must go through the fire. We cannot allow our trials and our situations, because Yahweh looks at those as small things. They're small things. Why? Because if you have the grain of a mustard seed, the Emunah, what the Torah says, it shall move mountains. It shall move trials. It makes you victorious. It makes you an overcomer, Yisrael. So we must walk in his Torah. We must establish his precepts, it says, that he will be our guide. He's made our guide. Saith Yahweh Almighty, let not your sins weigh you down, and let not your iniquities lift up themselves. Because iniquities will lift up themselves. It's like a viper. When you see a viper going through the grass, and it lifts up itself, there's only one thing that viper is going to do, or what it's preparing for, and that is to strike. So that's what our iniquities do. And we have our iniquities, and we hide them, or we allow them to rest in our bosom. That even though they lay low, they will rise up to strike, Yisrael. We find ourselves fighting against the Torah. We find ourselves not obeying the Zakein or the elders. Those that have an experience. Hallelujah. Those that have experienced something. I'm not just talking about just experiencing the word of the Torah, but has experienced life, has raised children, have been in the fields and worked and pulled cotton. The elders. So if we can't be instructed by elders because of this iniquity spirit, Yisrael, it's because it rises up as a viper. Hallelujah. Let's move on. Chapter 7, verse 77. He says this as a warning to Yisrael. He says, woe be to them that are bound with their sins. Not bound by their sins. Because we should not allow sins to bind us, Yisrael. Hallelujah. But it says bound with their sins. It seems like you can't shake it off, like you can't get away from it, Yisrael. He said, woe be unto them that are bound with their sins and covered with their iniquities, like as a field that is covered over with bushes, and a path thereof covered with thorns. You ever seen that, Yisrael? You ever seen a plot of land that has been cleared? You pass by the highway, you see a plot of land has been cleared, a field, that as the years go by, you go travel by that same highway, or that you see that same place, or it's a landmark that you go back to. If there's not anyone that is a caretaker or takes care of that plot or mows the grass, then what's going to happen? You're going to find bushes and trees and all kind of things growing. And after a while, it's going to look just like the woods that is down, a ways down from it. You can go back and look at a landmark or old place and not even recognize it because so much has grown up in it, Yisrael. And a path. You need a clear path through the woods. We have cut paths in the early years of the community, all kinds of paths through the woods, really. But if you look now, there's only one main path on the backside of the hill. Evidently, that path is still being walked because it's still there. Nothing's growing in it. But yet, the other paths we have cut through there, you out that hunt, you experience that. You cut a path one year and go back, that path is grown back up again. That's what iniquity does. That is what sin does. It grows up and it blocks the way that we should travel, the way that we must go, Yisrael. Covered with bushes, and the path thereof covered with thorns, that no man, it says no man, no one can travel through. So if we allow sin and iniquity, if we don't eradicate it, if we don't allow the fire of the mishpah of Almighty Yahweh to burn those impurities out of us, Yisrael, they're going to block our way. They're going to block our path. They're going to grow up as we are bound or tied with them, Yisrael. We're going to have to break the ties. We're going to have to allow the Torah of his word, of his fire, to continue to burn us, to purify us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There is a time of coming, Yisrael. Like they say, you haven't seen nothing yet. If you think you're going through something now, there's a time that is coming. And we must have the Torah, the Mishvah of Yahweh, written in our lips. Hallelujah. It must be written. I want to go to Judith, chapter 8, verse 24 through 27. I'm going to read that in Judith. Hallelujah. Oh, let us enjoy Yahweh's Shabbaton, Yisrael. For us to rest in his Torah. Hallelujah. Judith chapter 8, verse 24. Now, therefore, O brethren, let us show an example to our brethren. This is talking about those in Judah that were in the midst of a very trying situation. Being tried, they walked in the Torah, the Mishpah of Almighty Yahweh, but they did not obey the laws of the king or those statutes that were set before them at this time. It reminds me of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Yet, there were those that were torn and ripped asunder. Their limbs were amputated. Yisrael, we think we're going through something. What about these men in Judah that were being tried? And they did not turn away. Why? because they knew that there were others that would come after him. Don't you know Yahshua know we would have to come after him? Yes, right, y'all. And if he would have turned away, if Yahshua would have turned away, there would be no eternal hope for us. But because he saw the vision, he was the Torah, he knew the Torah, he stayed in the path that he endured all things. Why? Not only for his Abba, but because of us, Yisra'iyah. Because there's a Ahava for us. And if we Ahava, our Ach, and our hope, that when we're going through a certain trial or situation, we will show strength. We will show faith, Emunah. We will not fall, Yisra'iyah. Because there's someone going to be watching you. There's someone watching you, Yisra'iyah. Whether you believe it or not. I know I'm being watched. So what do I have to do as being a Zakein, as being an elder, as being a leader, Yisra'iyah? I must make sure that I'm walking circumspect to the Torah. Because I know I must be an example before my Ah. And not only this, out your Shibi, out your Wasada, they're with me just about 24-7. We out there working. And there's going to come a time where I'm going to have to pass it down to them. There's going to be times I have to bid jobs. I have to go look at a job. There's times I'm going to have to leave them. So what must I do? When I work, whether it's time or not, I must show my aunt how to tie that knot. And there's some tricky knots, aren't there? And don't think that a knot is not important. You just can't tie any knot. When you're working with trees, you're working with multiple thousands of pounds, just right, y'all, it's very dangerous. You have to know what you're doing. You can't go out there with just any kind of rope. It has to be a rope that is suited for the job. If you're cutting a piece of wood, it's going to weigh 400 or 500 pounds. Then you want a rope 2,000 or 3,000 pounds. Why? Because you know you have to have insurance in your equipment. You know that rope will hold that weight. So when I'm working, whether it's with a tool or whatever, I want my op to watch. I want to be an example. I can't be slowful and do something halfway, because what would that do? They would look at that and say, well, if he did it that way, and it may work for the first 2 or 3 times. If he did it that way, well, I'm going to do it that way because it's easier. And there's one Aki in particular I get on all the time, that you cannot shortcut things. You cannot shortcut things. You have to go the whole way. Why? Because this job is very dangerous. You can lose your life doing this. Oh, well, Yahweh watches over you. Yes, he watches over you, but you cannot be foolish either. So as I work, I know my aunt, they watch me work. Sometimes it's not a competition, but I don't want to say it brings fun into the job, but it's enjoyable. When you see your aunt pick up this log, well, I'm going to pick up that log. Well, I'm going to get 2 logs to the trailer to his 1 log. It's not a competition, but yet we know what one another can bear. And what happens? It don't matter how hard the job is or how long the job is, it gets done. That's the importance of it, that the job gets done. So in my example, I want the out to follow me in everything that I do. Whether it's climbing, there's a certain way you have to climb a tree. You just can't spike the tree and run up it. That's not how it works. You must balance yourself. You have to have two safety ropes at all times. So if you can't use one, you will have the other. Many times in the situation, I try to always use two. So when I'm away, I want my out to do things as I do. I want them to cut the tree just like I cut the tree. I want them to approach a situation, assess it, and do it the way I would do it. So is it with us, Yisra'iyah, that are going through trials, that are going through certain things? You can't go walking around, especially knowing what Yahshua has done. You have the Mishpah, you have Torah, you have the strength of your Ah and your Ho around you. But what you must do, you must endure the trial and go through, because there are those that are watching. That's what this is exclaiming here. Hallelujah. In Judith. Now, therefore, O brethren, let us show an example to our brethren, others, because their hearts, they do depend on us. I depend on those that are Zakein, that are older than I, that I see that are going through certain things in their bodies, or something in the physical family, or just a spiritual battle, Yisra'iyah. I depend on those. He said, because their hearts depend on us. It says, and the sanctuary, the bayit, and the house, and the altar, it all rests upon us. It's a great responsibility to be an elder in a Zakein. It's not nothing to play with, Yisra'iyah. He said, moreover, let us give todah unto Yahweh Almighty. First off, we must give todah to Yahweh Almighty, no matter what trial or what situation. Does it not say in everything give todah, Yisrael? Yeah. Hallelujah. Moreover, let us give todah, thanks unto Yahweh Almighty, which tries us. Yahweh, he tries us. Which tries us even as he did for our avos. Verse 26. Remember what things he did to Abram and how he tried Yitzhak. Then how he tried Yaakov? Yitzhak, Yisrael, yeah. And what happened unto Yaakov in Mesopotamia of Syria, where he kept the sheep of Laban, his mother's brother. For he has not tried us in the fire. What he was saying is that these trials that we're going through at this time, and you have to somewhat read some of this chapter. I'm trying to do so much reading today, Israel. But you can go back to Judah chapter 8 and read that chapter. You will understand the trials and the tribulation that this family went through. But at this time, they said that they were not tried in the fire as they were. They went through something much more difficult than what we're enduring now. For he has not tried us in the fire as he did them. For the examination of their lives, neither has he taken vengeance on us. But Yahweh both scourged them that come near unto him to admonish them. Hallelujah. So we have to come draw near unto Yahweh, that he may scourge us, that he may correct us, that he may admonish us. I mean, if your child, and we discipline our children here, but in order for you to make that switch touch, they have to come near, don't they? If we were children, I know when I was little, my mom and my avot did not play when it comes to the switch. Boy, come here. I'm not going to come to you. My dad, he would sit down. He would sit down and beat your butt. Boy, come here. Come on. Come here. He had that switch, and you don't want to come, but you know if you didn't come, if he got out of that chair, you knew you were really getting it. Come here, boy. So what do you have to do? What did I have to do? I know that I done wrong. I had to receive my just reward, so I had to draw near unto him to receive the reward. And what happened? Well, what should have happened, I should have come forth that with the experience that it not happened again. But we all know about that, don't we, Israel? Yeah. Hallelujah. Sometimes it takes more than one or two times. Hallelujah. So that's what he is saying here, Yisrael. But Yahweh doth scourge them that come near, that draw near to them, and to admonish them, to correct them, to chastise us, Yisrael. So that's why we're in the fire today, Yisrael. If you're going through a trial or a tribulation, those that may be listening to our VIV live stream, it's only the leading of Almighty Yahweh leading us by his fire. He knows how to divide the fire. He's not going to put more on you than you could bear, Yisrael. He knows what you need. My avot, he didn't beat me until I could not breathe. He knew what it would take to break me, to hold me over to the next time he had to tear my backside. Yahweh knows Yisrael, y'all. So don't turn away from the judgment of Almighty Yahweh. Don't turn away from his correction when he's correcting us. When we're in the midst of the fire, the heat, the burning, it's only to purify us, Yisrael, y'all. You have to turn the heat up. He has to turn the heat up in his last hour. Why? Because we're in a time of preparation. And if we are not ready, if we're not purified, then we will not enter in. We will not be able to endure. Hallelujah. And we must endure all things as a tough soldier, Yisrael. Let's go to Zechariah, another example. Zechariah chapter 13, verse 7. 13, verse 7. 7 to 9, I want to read. Then we're going to go to Giliana Revelations. Hallelujah. Draw us nearer, precious Yahweh. Unto the stick of Yahshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. There's none of us that endured that furnace or that fire or that trial like Yahshua endured for us, Yisrael. Hallelujah. So let us be willing to endure whatever he places before you. Whatever slice he gives to you, however hot the fire is, he knows what he's doing, Yisrael. Because it is Yahweh that divides the flame. Hallelujah. Of the fire. Zechariah chapter 13, verse 7. Awake, O sword, against my shepherd, and against the valiant warrior that is my fellow, saith Yahweh of hosts. Yahweh is saying to awake, O sword. He's going to have the sword taken out of the sheath where it rests, Yisrael. He says, smite the shepherd, and the sheep shall be scattered. And I will turn my hand upon the little ones. That sounds harsh, doesn't it, Yisrael? And it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith Yahweh, two parts therein shall be cut off. Cut off. Two parts shall be divided. I'm going to bring a wedge in the midst of this house, in the midst of the congregation, by my mitzvah. It's not going to rest, but I'm going to pull my two-edged sword out of its sheath. And I'm going to allow the shepherd to smite the flock that it may scatter. Don't you know that the flock has been scattered, Israel? This is Yahweh doing this. It is Yahweh that cleanses his house. It's Yahweh that divides. And what do we see here? We see here dividing this place or this house into three parts. Why? Why does he divide, Israel? Do we trust Yahweh? Do we have a moolah? Come on, Israel. Do we believe that he knows what he's doing? He knows what he's doing, Israel. So should we question him? Should we doubt him, Israel? Let me start again in verse 8. And it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith Yahweh, two parts therein shall be cut off and die. Two parts are going to be divided off, cut off. Now, not talk about slicing that cake or the trials being divided. Well, this is talking about the bear Israel being sliced, being divided, Israel. It shall be cut off and die. But the third shall be left therein. How many of us want to be part of that third, Yisrael? I want to be part of the living. I don't want to be that part that was divided, that was cut off from Almighty Yahweh. I want to be those that are counted in the living. Let us move on. Verse 9. And he said, I will bring the third part through the fire. Oh, we said that we wanted to be those that was living. We didn't want to be those that were cut off. But we that are alive today through the Dhamma Yahshua HaMashiach, we must go through what? We must go through the fire. We must go through the trials, Yisrael. It's not for us to abide in the midst of the fire forever. But until we are ready, until that gold is purified, hallelujah, it shall stay in the furnace. We should stay in the furnace, Yisrael. Until we are ready. He said, I will bring the third part through the fire, and will refine them as silver is refined. I don't know if you ever seen that. Silver. When it's refined, it's in a liquid form. It's very eye-catching. It's very beautiful. It's shiny. It flows. It doesn't discolor. Hallelujah. You got metals, when you put heat to them, they discolor. But it doesn't discolor. It's just a pure molten sheet, if I'm going to say, almost like glass, Yisrael. Like silver is refined, and I will try them as what? As gold is tried. How is gold tried? An intense heat. And the heat must get hotter and hotter and hotter, Yisrael. As gold is tried, that they shall call on my name. Do we call upon his name? Do we call upon the name of Yahweh in the midst of this fire, in the midst of this furnace, Yisrael? They shall call on my name, and I will answer them. Hallelujah. Oh my, it's nothing like someone answering back unto you when you're in the midst of trials. When it seems like you're all alone, when maybe you have fallen, you can't get up, you cry, you holler, you bellow. I feel like that sometimes. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm flesh just like all of us are flesh. And it seems like no matter who surrounds you, it seems like there's certain times when you're by yourself. And your heart cries, it might not come out of your mouth. Your mind, it cries out. Is anyone out there? There's almost no comfort. But what comforts me all the time is that I know Yahshua HaMashiach is with me. Hallelujah. Why? Because he speaks to me through his Torah, Yisrael. Now, I'm not one of those that say that he comes down and visits me every morning in my bedroom, strokes me on my head. He speaks kind, gentle words to me. No, I don't get that. I get something that is much more tangible than that, Yisrael. And what is that, Zakeh? What you got? I got his Torah written in my lap. Because if it was not for that, Yisrael, there's no way I could stand. No way I could stand. I'm a young man, 34 years old. There's no way I could stand, Yisrael. No way I could stand. Hallelujah. So I have to cry out. We have to cry out unto Almighty Yahweh in the midst of this furnace, in the midst of this fire, Yisrael. Hallelujah. He said, they shall call on my name. And what does he do? He said, I will answer them. He will answer us, Yisrael. If we cry out to him, hallelujah, cry out his name, Almighty Yahweh, he will answer us. And I will say, it is my people. Don't you know he knows who you are? Hallelujah. You don't have to tell him who you are. He knows who you are. Avot knows who his son is. No matter if he was a man that may have left his home or left his house, he knows when he sees that certain person, even though he might not recognize him physically, that he know those attributes, that he know that's his son. Yahweh knows we are his children, Yisrael. Even though we have not seen him, hallelujah, he looks upon us every day. As a matter of fact, he's looking upon us right now, Yisrael. Hallelujah. All you have to do is look up. Look up into the face of Yahshua. All we have to do is look up into the face of Almighty Yahweh. Hallelujah. Because his eye, the Torah says that his eye is upon the Tzaddik, upon the righteous, Yisrael. Hallelujah. So he's looking upon this house. He's looking upon Beit Yisrael today. He's looking right at you, those that are listening by via of live stream. Hallelujah. And I will say, it is my people, and they shall say, Yahweh is my Abba. Hallelujah. Let's all say that. I want us all, those of you that have the Torah, let us turn there. Zechariah chapter 13, verse 9. I want us to read that last portion. Hallelujah. Raise your hands when you're there. You there? Hallelujah. All right. Let's start with, I will say, okay? One, two, three. I will say, it is my people. And they shall say, Yahweh is my Abba. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yahweh is my Abba. He has birthed me. He has made me. Hallelujah. I am what I am today because of Almighty Yahweh. Not because of what I have done. Because if I would have did anything, I would be a mess. And I would not be here. But it's because my Abba, because he watches over me. He chastises me. He allows me to stay in the fire of trial and in the fire of temptation. Why? Because he loves me. He wants the best for me. He wants me to come forth in my last days as pure gold. He leads me by fire. He tries me by the fire of his word. He's not going to put more on me than I can bear. He knows how to cut. He knows how to divide. He knows those that are his. Hallelujah. And I can stand here today and say that Yahweh is my Abba. Hallelujah. Yahweh is my Abba. Isn't that tough to know, Yisrael? Hallelujah. Let us move to Revelation, Giliana, chapter 3, verse 15. I want to begin reading. Yahweh is my Abba. It is Yahweh that chastised me. Hallelujah. Even if it's by the hand of the enemy, it is Yahweh that chastised me. If there is someone that has something blasphemous, ugly to say about me, that's all right. Because I know it is Yahweh that chastises me. It is Yahweh that corrects me. Hallelujah. Get y'all in Revelation chapter 3, verse 15. I want to begin reading. Yahweh says, I know your works, that you are neither cold nor hot. Yahweh knows our works. He knows when we are hot. He knows when we are cold, Yisrael Yah. He knows when we have the munah to believe. And he knows when we do not have the munah to believe, Yisrael Yah. He said, I know your works, that you are neither hot or cold. He said, I would that you were hot or cold. So then because you are lukewarm, we are a lukewarm generation, Yisrael Yah. You might as well just come to grips with it. Hallelujah. Or if it had not been for Yahshua on our side, hallelujah, we're lukewarm people. Because we are neither hot nor cold, he said, I will spew you out of my mouth. Verse 17. He said, because you say I am rich and increase with goods, I have need of nothing. Have you ever said that? Yisrael Yah, I am rich. I got enough. I don't need Yahweh to do that. I got that. I know what I'm doing. He said, because you say I am rich, that I am increased with good, that I have all that I need. We know that all that we need is in Yahshua HaMashiach. He said, and have need of nothing. Don't you know and know not that you are a wretch and that you are miserable and that you are poor and blind, and not only that, you're naked. We don't possess anything, Yisrael Yah. Anytime you lift yourself up and say, I'm above that reproof. I'm above that correction. Even though at the time it seems though that it's not to you. I wasn't the one. I wasn't the perpetrator. That's not the issue. The issue is a correction. We should receive correction. Hallelujah. We should receive Mishpat and Torah. There was time in my life that I received correction. I was not the perpetrator. I'll give you an example. My brothers and I, there was one instance where they were doing something they wasn't supposed to do. Well, me being the oldest, I should have said, no, don't do that. You'll get in trouble. Don't do that. But I saw them do it, and they got in trouble, and I got in trouble. Did not Cain say to Yahweh, am I my brother's keeper? Well, we are our brother's keeper. I am my aunt's keeper. So there's going to be times that we, as our Cain, as being older ones, that we're going to receive reproof. Because why? Because we didn't give the right instruction, or we did not instruct Yisrael Yah. So instruction, no matter how it comes to you, Yisrael Yah, it is tough. It is tough. It is to correct you. It is to bring you in the way and to keep you in the way. Well, I was reproved for something I didn't do. It was to keep you in the way. But what you was reproved for, don't do it. See, we don't think that way. We want to hold a grudge. Well, I got rebuked. I didn't even do that. I wasn't the one that did it. Well, maybe you should have been the one to pick it up, to clean it up, to straighten it up. Maybe you were the one that saw that one, and you should have said something to that one. Or maybe you should have been the one that should have been more enlightened, or had your eyes open, or had your guards up. Oh, there's always room for correction, Yisrael Yah. We're not over the correction of Almighty Yahweh. Are we over this today? Is Yahweh missing tomorrow? He's not missing me. I'm in the fire up here. Hallelujah, but I'm glad I'm in the fire. Why? Because it keeps me walking straight, upright. Hallelujah. Lead me by your pillar of fire by night in this dark generation, Almighty Yahweh. Verse 18. He said, I counsel you to buy of me gold. Now, this gold is not just any kind of gold, Yisrael Yah, because you can get gold just about anywhere. There are different grades of gold. There's some gold that's got things in it. I remember going to the mines as a child on the field trips, and they got what they call fool gold. It looks like gold, but it's not really gold, but it's gold. It's gold, but it doesn't have any value, in other words, Yisrael Yah. So what Yahweh wants us to buy of him, we think we have what we need. We think we got it all, but we have nothing. We are yet naked. So he counsels of us. He said, I counsel you to buy me gold, but not just any kind of gold. Gold tried in the fire. Hallelujah. So you know, if Yahweh is counseling us to buy him gold that has been tried in the fire, that gold's right. There's not going to be any purities. Yahweh's not going to give us anything impure, Yisrael. If he say, buy this, believe me, it's of the utmost quality. There's nothing that can match it. So he says, I counsel you. Listen, I'm counseling you. I'm telling you what to do. You think you have it all, but you don't, Yisrael. Buy of me gold, try in the fire. Why? That you may be rich. That those of us that have been in the world thought we had it all. Thought we were making it. We was all right, but we didn't have nothing. We didn't have nothing without this gold. So he says, buy me gold that you may be rich, and white raiment that you may be clothed, that we would not be naked. Should we not have cast out the garments that is spotted by the flesh and put on the garment of Siddiq, of righteousness, Yisrael, a white garment? He says, that you may be clothed, and that the shame of your nakedness not appear. Don't you know that Adam and Eve knew that they was naked only after they sinned before Almighty Yahweh? Really, there was no such thing as nakedness. But because they sinned before Almighty Yahweh, and that aspect of sin, because Yahweh could see that, and he showed them what they have done, then there came the nakedness. Why? Because the Torah of Yahweh judged them. He left them with a Torah, did not eat. They disobeyed the Torah, and then from that they saw the nakedness. They saw the sin, Yisrael. He said, be clothed, that the shame of your nakedness do not appear, and that I may anoint your eyes with the eye salve. Anoint us, Yah. Hallelujah, with the eye salve. That we may see. Verse 19. He says this. The gold, concerning the gold, Israel, he's talking about the gold. He said, as many as I love, I rebuke and I chasten. Chastening, rebuke, reproof, the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. That's what it does. It rebukes, it reproves us, it teaches us, it directs us. That is the gold that Yahweh is talking about for us to buy of him. As many as I love, I rebuke, I chasten. And he says, to be zealous, therefore, and repent. Are we zealous to repent today, Israel? Understanding our shortcomings and our downfalls, that we did not meet the mark, even as we entered into the body of Almighty Yahweh. He says, be zealous, therefore, and repent. Verse 20. He says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, he said, I will come in unto him. Let us open the door of our lips, of our mind unto Almighty Yahweh. Let us not lock the door of our ears, of our lips, of our hearts, but let us hear what the Ruach is saying. Sure, I'm speaking to us, Yisrael, but there's the soft, gentle voice of Yahshua HaMashiach in his Torah. And we should not lock him out. We should not lock the door. He said, and I will come in, and I will sup with him. I will sup. I will stay there. I will eat. I will dine with you. I will be with you. I will congregate with you. And you or he with me. Don't we want to sup with Yahshua HaMashiach? Don't we want to enter into his bayit? Hallelujah. Into his courts with praise, with thanksgiving. Come into his bayit and sup with him, Yisrael. Verse 21. He said, to him that overcomes. How should we overcome? Well, we must endure. For the race is not given to the swift, nor to the strong, but those that endure this furnace, that endures this race, that endure these trials, that endure this temptation, what? Until the very end. Until we are complete, to have made pure as gold. He said, I will grant him to sit with me in my throne, my. I don't think we understand what kind of privilege that is. Men count it privileges to sit just with the governor, to sit with the congressman, to sit with the CEOs, to be invited to a banquet to sit with the president. Man, how would you even prepare for that? I wouldn't know how to prepare for something like that. But to sit with Yahshua HaMashiach at his right hand on the throne, Yisrael, he said, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Abba on his throne. Well, I'm going to lay claim to that. Hallelujah. Did he say his Abba? Do we not read together that Yahweh is our Abba, Yisrael? So there's a place for us, hallelujah, in his Melchizedek, in his kingdom, Yisrael. Just be patient, Yisrael. He's preparing us. We're in the furnace, we're in this fire, and it has not got to the hottest of hot just yet. Hallelujah. But keep your faith, keep the emunah. Let us go back to where he has written his Torah in our hearts, Yisrael, that we may endure and overcome all things. Hallelujah. Because this fire is really a trial. It's hot. At times it does burn. Hallelujah. But the burning is just a purification. If you remember that, well, I'm going through something and I'm wavering. It seems like I can't stand. Well, that's the purification. That's the purification. That's your weakness. That's the purification. So allow it to burn it out of you, Yisrael, that we may become as pure as gold. Hallelujah. Let us move on, Yisrael, to 1 Kefi chapter 4, verse 11. Kephar, he understood this. Hallelujah. That there was a trial. Torah brings to mind even the rich young ruler as Yahshua spoke to him. That was a trial for him. That was a fire for him. What, to take all his possessions and to give it to the poor? That's a hard thing. I don't know if I can endure that. That was a type of fire, whether you want to realize it or not. Did he endure? No. He didn't go through the fire. He turned back. There are those that want to follow or said that they will follow Yahshua HaMashiach. I will be a disciplined one. But before I do that, I got to go do this. I got to bury my avad. I got things I got to take care of. I got to go back and tell my family that I may not see them anymore. That was a type of trial. That was a type of fire. There were those that wanted to go back. He said, let the dead bury the dead. Come on, I have eternal life. Don't worry about that. Hallelujah. Don't go back to your family because they're not going to understand. They're not going to understand you walking in the Torah in the midst while you following me. They're not going to understand that. That's a trial for us all, Israel. Hallelujah. 1 Kefi chapter 4, verse 11. He said, if any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of Almighty Yahweh. If any man minister, let him do it as of the strength which Yahweh gives. Not of his own strength, but the strength that Yahweh gives him. That Yahweh in all things may be magnified and honored through Yahshua HaMashiach, to whom the praise and the manifest power forever and ever. It is so, and let it be fulfilled. Verse 12. Beloved, think it not strange concerning, what does it say there, somebody? The fiery trial. It doesn't say the fiery trials. Of course, there are many trials, but there's one specific one he is talking right here, Yisrael. Beloved, think it not strange, the fiery trial, which is to try you. Now, that one we haven't got to yet. As though some strange thing has happened to you. Sure, there are many things we go through, Yisrael, we think it's strange, but it's not this trial. This is the final of trials. The test, or the last of the tests, Yisrael, he's talking about here. But yet, it can be applied to any situation, Yisrael. Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial, which is to try you, as though something has happened unto you, some strange thing. But he says this, but rejoice. Hallelujah. But rejoice. In that trial, rejoice. In that temptation, rejoice. But rejoice, In as much as you are partakers. We don't even think about that. We don't. No, we don't. We don't think about that. Maybe in the latter or, but in the first beginning stages, we don't think about what Yahshua had went through. You are partakers. Think of this. This will give you the strength that you need to press on. That you are partakers of Messiah Yahshua's suffering. That when his splendor shall be revealed, you may be glad also with exceeding joy. If you be reproached for the name of Yahshua HaMashiach, he says, happy are you. That's a type of trial. Come on, we've all gone through that. His name is what? Oh, his name is God, Lord. We've been calling him that for years. Now, I'm telling you, his name is Yahshua. We've gone through that one. He says, happy are you, for the Ruach of splendor in Yahweh do rest upon you. On their part, he is evil spoken of. How many of you experienced that? On their part, the name of Yahshua HaMashiach, it's evil spoken of. It's evil spoken of. They mock, they scoff at it. Oh, that was for the Yahudim. That was back then. This is a new generation. No. For that part, he is even spoken of, but on your part, because we know who he is, Israel. We know why that trial or that circumstance comes forth. But on your part, he is exalted. Hallelujah. Did I say there was a part for us, Israel? Each part, he knows how to divide the parts. Verse 15. But let none of you suffer as a murmurer. Now, we have to understand this, Israel. There are trials that we must go through. Sure, there's fiery trials in this furnace that is so hot. But if we suffer, let it not be because we are murmurers or we complainers. Let it not be, as it says, as a thief. Because we have stolen, we have taken. Or as an evildoer. Or as a busybody. Don't let your trials or what you're suffering be because you are a busybody. Because you're receiving just recompense or reward of what you have received unto yourself, Israel. A busybody in other men's affair. Verse 16. Yet if any man suffers as a kedusha, let him not be ashamed, but let him magnify and honor Yahweh on his behalf. You're not honoring or bringing magnification to the name of Yahweh because you suffer as a busybody of an evildoer, Yisrael. You only bring honor or strength to his name because you suffer as one as being tzaddik, as being righteous, walking his Torah. Verse 17. For the time has come that judgment must begin in what? The house of Yahweh, the bayit of Yahweh. And if it first begin at us or begins here, Yisrael, what shall be the end of them that obey not the message of Almighty Yahweh? So we're going through trials and tribulation, and the judgment of Yahweh starts here in the bayit. Then what about those that are not in the hands of Yahshua HaMashiach? If we're going through this fiery trial, then what shall be for the unrighteous? Those that walk against Almighty Yahweh, they're against Almighty Yahweh. And if the righteous scarcely be saved, what is scarcely? Scarcely is so close that it almost seemed like the object hit it, but it didn't hit it. If you're shooting a pistol or a rifle at a target, you're just sure that your aim is just true. Then when you go look at the paper, it's just a little bit off. You really can't call it. It's not a bullseye, but it's so close you want to call it a bullseye. But those that are shooting at that same target, they're not going to give you that. You didn't hit the bullseye. But it's scarcely. It's real close. He said, the righteous scarcely be saved. Where shall those that are unrighteous, that are not tzaddik, that are sinners, that walk against the Torah of Almighty Yahweh, and the sinner appear, Yisrael. Hallelujah. So if that sets this fiery trial for us, that we go through this fire, and we are deemed as righteous, walking in the Torah of Mitzvah of Almighty Yahweh, then what is the wicked man, what is he going to endure? What is he going to go through, Yisra'iyah? Verse 19. Wherefore, let them that suffer according to the will of Almighty Yahweh commit the keeping of their souls unto him. Yahweh knows what he's doing. Yahweh has brought us this far by Emunah, Yisra'iyah. Come on. He knows what he's doing. So let us allow him to move us from faith to faith, as the old condition would say. Higher heights in Yahshua HaMashiach. I'm going to read that again. Therefore, let them that suffer according to the will of Yahweh commit the keeping. Trust him. Have Emunah. Commit the keeping of their nephesh. Do you commit the keeping of your nephesh, of your soul, to Almighty Yahweh? Or to Yahshua the Dawn of Yahshua HaMashiach? To him in well-doing. So we allow Yahweh to keep us, Yisra'iyah. It's for our well-doing. It's for our well-being. As to a faithful creator. Is he not a faithful creator? Do not we see the sun rise in the morning, Yisra'iyah? Don't you see it set? Even those that have passed, Yahweh is still faithful. Because the sun still rises, the sun set. Hallelujah. Yahweh is faithful. Don't we receive the rain in due season? And even the sun, the heat of it in due season, Yahweh is faithful. Hallelujah. So let us commit our being, ourselves unto Almighty Yahweh. For he knows what we need. He knows we need chastisement. We need the fire of his correction. Hallelujah. So let us allow him to carry us on, Yisra'iyah. Hallelujah. For we must press forward. We're in the path, we're in the way, but we're not to the kingdom just yet. Hallelujah. Not just yet, Yisra'iyah. But Yahweh knows that what he has started in us, he's going to finish it. Hallelujah. We shall get there, Yisra'iyah. Hallelujah. Don't doubt. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's go to 1 Kefah, chapter 1, verse 1. First Kefah, chapter 1, verse 1, as I begin reading. Yahweh, he divides the flame of fire, Yisra'iyah. He knows exactly what he's doing. It says in the first verse of the first chapter of Kefah 1, Kefah, an apostle of Yahshua HaMashiach, to the strangers scattered throughout Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia. Verse 2. Elect according to the foreknowledge of Yahweh our Abba, through being made Kodesh of the Ruach, to the obedience and the sprinkling of the Dom of Yahshua HaMashiach. He says the free unmerited pardon to you, and shalom be multiplied. Blessed be Yahweh our Abba of our master Yahshua HaMashiach, which according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a lively hope by the resurrection of Yahshua HaMashiach from the dead. To an inheritance, Yisra'iyah, incorruptible and undefiled, that fades not away, reserved in the Shemayims for who? For you, for us. And are kept by the power. Do we understand the power of Almighty Yahweh? Did not I just read that we should allow our nephesh to be to the keeping of Almighty Yahweh? Who are kept by the power through Emunah to what? To salvation. Ready to be revealed in the last time. Are we ready, Yisra'iyah? Hallelujah. Did I not speak of the trial? So we must go through that trial. Hallelujah. That we may be ready in the last time. Verse 6. Wherein you greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, you are in heaviness through manifold temptations. Verse 7. That the trial of your faith be much more precious than that of gold that perishes. So gold perishes, Yisra'iyah. Even though we use it many times as an example, yet it perishes. But we are that which Yahweh has invested in us to be tried, to be purified. It should never perish, Yisra'iyah. That the trial of your emunah be much more precious than that of gold that perishes, though it be tried with fire, might be found to the praise and the honor and splendor at the appearing of Yahshua HaMashiach. I want to be there at the appearing, Yisra'iyah. I want to be that gold that has been tried, hallelujah, made prepared or made ready for the appearing of Yahshua HaMashiach. In verse 8, whom having not seen, you love. Hallelujah. Do we love him? We have never seen him. But yet he shows us daily his ahava for us. How can you not love somebody that shows you love? Even though you may not show them love. There's a turning point somewhere. Hallelujah. There's going to be a turning point somewhere, Yisra'iyah. Whom having not seen, you love. In whom though you now that in whom though now you see him not, yet believing, you rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of honor and praise. Hallelujah. Receiving the end of our faith. What is that end? What is the end of our munah? What is the end of that purging process of this pure gold? What is the end of it, Yisra'iyah? Even the salvation of your nephesh. That is the end of us, Yisra'iyah. It is the salvation of our souls. It's for the saving or the separating unto his purpose, Yisra'iyah. And that question about where does the sinner go? Well, there's a place prepared. The same place that has been prepared for the melechim or the angels that fell. It is hell, Yisra'iyah. It is separation from Almighty Yahweh. And as we Torah describes hell, we know there is fire there. There's a perpetual burning that never ceases, that never ends. But yet this burning that we're going through has an end, Yisra'iyah. It has an end. It has a climatic end. What is that? It's the salvation of our souls. So let us endure. Let us endure the burning. Let us endure the trial. Let us endure the battle as tough soldiers, or as Rayot would say, as warriors. That we're willing to lay down our life. A warrior knows what he's laying down his life for. He knows what he's given his life to. And we have given our lives to Yahshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. Just a few more verses, Yisra'iyah, as I bring this message to a close. Hallelujah. I pray it's been an inspiration to your life. Hallelujah. Stay in the fire. Don't jump out. Don't jump out of the fire. Well, it burns, our king. That's just the impurities being burned, my friend. Hallelujah. It's not going to last forever. You're going to become immune to it. You'll be immune to the fire. Once that gold is purified and all the stuff that's in it that should not be, it's immune. There's no more burning in that gold. There's no more purifying. So you can put that gold, leave that gold in the heat, and it's just pure gold. You can turn that furnace up, it's just pure gold. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. No matter how hot that furnace got, their clothes weren't singed. Their shoes, their sandals were still yet on their feet. There was not a hair on their head. That was harm. Well, that's hard to believe, Zakeh. I believe it. It's not a head. Is there a head on your head harm, Yisra'iyah? No. No. Abide in the Torah and abide in the mitzvah, Yisra'iyah. Hallelujah. And that was part of the message, Yisra'iyah. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, but I will finish this. Hallelujah. I want us to enjoy the Shabbat. Not that we're not enjoying the Shabbat here in the Bayit. Hallelujah. But we have a time of fellowship and rest before Almighty Yahweh. Let me end this in Isaiah. I'm going to read Isaiah chapter 43, 1 through 7. I still have a few minutes, actually. But I'm going to stop right there, Yisra'iyah. Isaiah chapter 43, verse 1 through verse 7. It says, but now, thus saith Yahweh, that has created you, O Yaakov. Yahweh has created us, Yisrael. And he that had formed you, he has made us, he has shaped us. He formed us into who we are, to our vessels, what we are today. O Yisrael. He says, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have saved you. Like a bird out of the snare of the fowler, Yisrael. Yahweh has let us go. He has redeemed us. He has saved us. He said, I have called you by your name. You mean he knows my name? He calls you by your name. Every time you awaken, Yisrael, he calls you by your name. He knows your name. And let me tell you this. He knows your name that is written upon that precious stone that you don't even know. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even though we bear names in this life, he's got a name for you. So I tell you what, if you want to see what that name is, endure through this fire. Come on, Yisrael. Endure the fire. Endure the trials. Endure the flames. I want to see what that new name is. He said, you are mine. He said, when you pass this through the waters, he said, I will be with you. Was not Yahshua with those disciples in the water, Yisrael? He said, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. He said, even when you walk through the fire, hallelujah, I'm going to hold on to that, Yisrael. I'm walking through the fire, but I know Yahshua, he's with me. He said he will never leave us, and he will never forsake us, that he will be always near unto us. It reminds me of the song, he says he's just a prayer away. He's just a cry away. He hears those that cry unto him. He's not far, Yisrael. Hallelujah. He's right here in our lives. Hallelujah. He said, even though you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned. Hallelujah. Neither shall the flame kindle upon you. Did the flame kindle upon Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Why? Why, Yisrael? Why? He said, before I am Yahweh, and not only that, I am your Abba. The Kodesh word of Yisrael, your Savior. He said, I gave Egypt for your ransom. So I paid for you. You're not going nowhere. He said, Cush and Sheba for you, nations for us. He said, since you were precious in my sight, don't you know that we were precious in Yahweh's sight? And even when we were not lovely to look upon, and still we're far from that, but yet in the eyes of Yahweh, we are perfect, Israel. He sees the end of us. Hallelujah. He sees the end of it. He know what it takes. He know how to divide the fire. He says, since you are precious in my sight, you have been honorable. I have loved you. Therefore will I give Adams or nations, men for your lives, for you, and people for your life. He's not going to let us go, Yisrael. He's going to protect us. He's going to keep us. Fear not, for I am with you. I will bring your Zerah from the east and gather you from the west. He's going to bring us all into one place, Yisrael. He's going to bring us all into his Melkut. Hallelujah. All into his kingdom. He said, I will say to the north, give it up. And to the south, don't hold back. He says, bring forth my sons from afar and my daughters from the ends of the earth. Hallelujah. I recall the old ones, even in the churches that I was brought up in. They were all talking about the gathering in the Melkut. It's going to be a time of praise, a time of dancing, and a time of singing. This is what this is foretelling us, Yisrael. This is our end. When we get through this fire, this is our place right here, Yisrael. Verse 7. Even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my honor. And he said, I have for him, yes, I have made him. Hallelujah. For it is Yahweh that has formed us, Yisrael. It is Yahweh that has made us. He know what it's going to take, whether he have to cut us. A little here and a little there. He's going to put us in the furnace of fire of this trial that we become pure. Don't you know he's preparing us for his crown? Yisrael, we are his crown. He knows what he is doing. So let us not forget all that Yahweh is doing for us. But Zacchaeus, I'm going through a trial. You're just going through the fire. He leads us by the fire, Yisrael. He purifies us by the trial. He shows what is in us. If nothing else, trials really show you what you are made of. Hallelujah. He would not put more on us than we could bear, Yisrael. Let us uphold his emunah, what he has given us, Yisrael, and let us grow. Hallelujah. In all things. Hallelujah. Don't jump out of the fire. Stay in the fire. Hallelujah. Stay in the trial. For Yahweh Almighty, he will bring us forth as pure gold. He is the Abba. He is Yahweh that divides the flame of the fire. Hallelujah. Isn't that tough, Israel, y'all to know? Hallelujah. He's in control of all things. I know many times it's easy to say, I know, but he's in control of all things, Israel. Don't give Satan any space. He's just been charged. He don't even know. He's been charged of Almighty Yah. He's just doing what Yahweh has allowed and commanded him to do. And he's doing it, is he not? Well, let us do what he has commanded us to do, Yisrael. Hallelujah. He has made Satan that we may stomp him in the ground. Hallelujah. Don't let him rise up. Just stomp him in the ground. Don't even get that old snake a chance to raise his head off. Cut it up. Cut it off, Yisrael. Yahweh's giving you the power to do that through his Mishrach, through his Torah. Hallelujah. Let us stand to our feet, Yisrael. I pray that this simple truth be an inspiration to your love, Yisrael. That your Nashfish. And I pray for you all that are listening by Viv live stream, that's looking at this video, this broadcast by live stream. Don't give up hope. Hallelujah. For it is Yahweh that allows us to go through and to endure many things. Yahshua HaMashiach has endured everything for us. Though we're not willing to endure for him, Yisrael. Let us endure for him. Let us show the Ahava he has shown for us. Well, what is that, Zakeh? He endured unto the end. Your pressing is no good until you endure to the end. So let us endure to the end, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Abba Yahweh, we do Baraki for all things. We do thank you for your Ruach that has dwelled in the house and in the hearts of Yisrael on this day. We do ask, Abba Yahweh, that you would take the Zakeh home, the Aholt home, Yah, all those that travel here for near and far home safely, and that your Ruach will camp round about them. And also, as we remember, Abba Yahweh, Re'at Dawi Yisrael, his Isha, you give them strength, and the meeting there, Abba Yahweh, that you will pour out your Ruach in a mighty way. In all things, we do barak you, and we do give you Todah. In the mighty name of Yahshua HaMashiach, we do all pray, and we cry out, Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah, Yahweh! Hallelujah! Yah barak you all, Kedushim.